Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.
Hello and welcome to Nirmal Bang, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hira Daria. We have with us Riya Singh, technical analyst, currencies joining in. Riya, welcome to the show. Riya, let's start with regards to what's happening on the rupee. There was strength that we were seeing in the last couple of sessions. However, it seems that the rupee is continuing to remain in consolidation. What's the way forward from here?
So the strength in the rupee was reflective of the weakness in the dollar index that we had seen in the last few sessions. Now, the weakness that is coming in into the Indian rupee is probably due to the negative numbers that have come in with respect to the economic outlook. And if you look at the statement from the RBI, there is a downside revision to the GDP as well. So I think the consolidation phase that we are currently seeing right now could be said that there is this, it needs to be in a range where it doesn't hurt the RBI commitment to the government borrowings as well as the exports, which have just seen, picking up. So owing to the scheduled, buying that will be happening from the RBI in the government securities on the June 17. So there will be a purchase that will happen with respect to the third tranche. So owing to this, I think there could be a little more consolidation phase that could be seen into the rupee. So look for a range of around 73.45 to 72.90.
Right, so that's with regards to where the Indian rupee goes. Moving on to the dollar as well, clearly if you go to see, a lot of people are anticipating that the liquidity could be tightened from here on. There are concerns with regards to inflation as well. How do you see the dollar moving from here on?
Yeah, so the inflation is a very, the recent hot topic into the US because it is moving beyond the benchmark that the Fed has set. Now, as regards to this speculation, I think there was a pretty much good numbers with respect to the CPI. So there was a huge gain of 4.2% into the CPI. So this is what triggered the speculation that there can be a tapering that can happen into the massive stimulus program. But if you look at the recent non-farm payroll numbers, they have come quite weaker than the expectation. So this has released some pressure off that speculation, owing to the Fed commitment that there won't be any tapering that will happen into the stimulus program or the withdrawal into the fiscal support unless the whole employment numbers are, the whole recovery is done into the employment numbers and so on. So I think there won't be much of the withdrawal or tightening of the policy. It will continue with the current accommodative stance and to hold off the rate for now. So I think as far as dollar index is concerned, it will be in between 90-50 and 90-10 in the coming days.
But Riya, what do you make of the Japanese yen as well? Because clearly if you see the economic indicators, they are seeming to be weak. They are facing another wave already with regards to the pandemic. How do you think that could impact the currency?
See, the weakness into the Japanese yen will be coming forward because, like you said, they are not being very much able to handle the pandemic wave as compared to the countries like US, UK, and Eurozone altogether. So there is a roadblock that they are facing in covering that. And the inflation is another issue that the Japan is facing. There is a downgrade into the GDP numbers as well. So if you look at the current GDP numbers, they have come in at a weaker note. So all in all together, there is not much of a positivity that could be seen into the yen, at least on a shorter term. So unless there is some pickup into the vaccination now, yes, the Prime Minister have promise that there will be a pickup into the COVID-19 vaccination drive altogether. But unless there is some numbers that could be seen from these promises, I don't think so. There could be much pickup into the economy and thus into the yen altogether. So weakness will continue into the Japanese yen.
Right. So, Ria, what are the strategies that you would want to recommend?
So, I think one should go long into the Euro INR above the level of 89.08 with the stop loss at 88.90. Keep a target at 89.20, 89.30. Go long into the JPY INR as well. Look for a breakout of 66.90 with the stop loss at 66.77 and target at 67.10, 67.25. You can also go long into the USD INR above 73.25 for a target of 73.40, 73.50 with a stop loss at 73.10. The major support into the USD INR is at 70-90.
All right. Thank you, Ria. Thank you so much for sharing the strategies as well and giving your views. Thank you, participants, as well. Uh-huh.